5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, all engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff.
Now, I was reading an article yesterday, and it had Tim Draper talking about how millennials should be buying Bitcoin. And I have to disagree, not 100%, in the aspect of for you to retire, you should be buying Bitcoin. And it's not that I'm against Bitcoin. I actually do see Bitcoin go into the prices of, you know, north of 50,000, 100,000. But when you're talking about returns on investment and different ways to have income, the shift should be Ethereum, because if we're talking about a Bitcoin being at 100,000, which to me is not something that is not possible. I actually believe it's highly probable. 2021, 2022, we could be seeing, if not 100,000, somewhere near around the 100,000. But again, it's all about the return on investment. And to me, the low-hanging fruit is Ethereum. When you compare, and I'm just comparing Ethereum to Bitcoin for return on investment, not on, you know, technology. Well, I'm not even talking about developers. I'm just talking about return on investment and the easier approach for someone to hold with less. I don't like this word, but I'll use it here. Anxiety, right? Because from wherever it is you're getting it under 10,000 of Bitcoin, and then to hold all the way through to a, you know, somewhere near 100,000, there's going to be a lot of up and down. But when you're acquiring Ethereum, really what you, I mean, imagine if you're trying to get the same similar gains from Ethereum or from Bitcoin, you can get it from Ethereum going from 100. Ethereum not too long ago was at $120. So Ethereum going to $1,000, which was previous all-time high, was like around $1,400. And if you're stacking up, again, I'm comparing the prices of Bitcoin and Ethereum, right? And not only that, with the fundamentals, the stories, the data that's coming in with Ethereum, it's, again, to me, it's low-hanging fruit. It's actually, there's actually more bullish news on Ethereum than there is on Bitcoin. But with that being said, I still believe Bitcoin will be going to those levels. Again, understand what I'm saying. The return on investment. And again, Bitcoin's all-time high is 20,000, around there. Ethereum, I believe, is 1,400. So for you to get, let's say you have, you know, I believe with one Bitcoin or the equivalent of one, around one Bitcoin or 1.5 Bitcoin, I believe you can have close to, if not 100 Ethereum. I know I have a lot of Ethereum, and I'm just saying, so if Ethereum goes to, let's say, not even 1,400, 1,000, and you have 100 Ethereum, you have now $100,000. Of course, you put in probably about 6,000, 7,000. I got to do the math on it. I haven't even recently checked. But depending where you're getting, and remember, again, Ethereum was sitting at $120, even lower hanging fruit. You know, it dropped even lower, and that's where, I mean, I really got aggressive. Another play I would say is Bitcoin Cash when it's under $200. I was acquiring Bitcoin Cash when it was at $100. Seeing it around there and now seeing where it's at, again, I could see Bitcoin Cash around, 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 US dollars, 7,000 US dollars. Imagine Bitcoin at 100,000, then do the math where you can probably see Bitcoin Cash. I mean, you look at the tokenomics, you look at the things that are happening. So for me, I would have to disagree with Tim Draper for those who really want the bigger bang on return, it wouldn't be Bitcoin. Again, I'm not coming against Bitcoin. I like Bitcoin. I do believe there's great returns on investment from different asset classes. But when you're talking about cryptos and you have, you know, the second largest crypto at 160, fluctuating from 160, 170, even as low as 120 not too long ago. I think, not financial advice, but I just strongly believe with all the data, the information that's surrounding Ethereum, that the great return on investment is on Ethereum more. So if I was, you know, giving an opinion, I would be saying, hey, listen, yes, Bitcoin has, you know, there's a great chance that it's going to 100,000. But I mean, not everybody is strong enough to hold from, you know, a Bitcoin, especially the amount of money you have to dish out to get a Bitcoin or two Bitcoins and then hold it all the way to 100,000, which is like five times from all-time highs, when you can almost get the same amount, if not more, with Ethereum, depending when you're acquiring Ethereum, just going to recent all-time highs, right? So if Bitcoin's at 100,000 and Ethereum goes to 4,000 or 3,000, you have more leverage to the upside to really, you know, maybe you can drop 30% or 40% of Ethereum when it gets to all-time highs. You can hold 60% and, you know, play a little bit there, hold off a little bit, and still make more returns on your investment than holding Bitcoin. So for me, I know a lot of us get blinded by things and we just stick to it. We can't be so rigid in our thinking and kind of just have an open mind and say, wait a minute, I think the smarter play, especially with all the information that there is on Ethereum, you know, what's happening with Ethereum developers. I made a video about Fidelity, a lot of big names that are surrounding with Ethereum. I strongly believe that the real return on investment, the smarter play, in my opinion, not financial advice, just give me my humble opinion, is on Ethereum. I'll close it here. So again, imagine holding Bitcoin from 6,000, 7,000, 8,000 and holding it all the way through to 100,000. It's really, we're talking about really stressful stuff. I like easy flow. I like giving myself leverage. And I want to be able to make the same amount with less stress, less capital to put in. And it has, again, in my opinion, Ethereum has more bullish news surrounding it. When you look at all the things that are happening with decentralized finance, developers, you know, names like Fidelity, names like Bakkt, things that are happening, and the staking, smart money, institutional money that's going to want to have Ethereum to stake, and I mean, there's so much bullish news. You just got to be patient. Again, not financial advice, but just from my point of view, to me, the smarter investment, again, not financial advice, but just my opinion, is the smarter play is Ethereum, looking at all these different things. I don't just look at the money angle. I look at my stress angle. Am I going to be, oh my goodness, I got to wait till, you know, Bitcoin's at 60,000. Now there's, you know, is it going to go to 100,000 when, and I put already so much into it. I put 30,000 into it. You know, just to, you understand, there's a lot of people that are really not seeing the mathematics here. They're just getting caught up by the numbers. And, you know, one day Bitcoin will be at $1 million. Yeah, one day. But how long are you going to be able to hold from the peaks and crashes? Because there will be peaks and crashes. And, you know, if you're familiar with this, it just doesn't go up and up and up. So you need to give yourself leverage. So I look at Ethereum at 120, very aggressive. At 150, aggressive. Anything under 150, 140, I get to that level where it's very aggressive. I get really aggressive for Ethereum, which I have been, and I'm very happy with my Ethereum stack. So again, I have so much leverage that all I need for it to do to get kind of the same, and it's even actually more return on investment, because you know, for you to get, let's say you're getting into Bitcoin now around 8,000, and it gets to 100,000, you're dishing out 8,000 to get one Bitcoin, when I believe you can get around 100 Ethereum. I haven't done the math yet, but I'm pretty sure if it's not less, like less capital to get 100 Ethereum, it's pretty much the same thing, depending, because remember, you know, cryptos move pretty crazy. So 100 Ethereum at $118, $120, depending the cost average of how many Ethereums you're getting around that time, from 160, depending where you got it, right? But again, I've been saying this, that I've been really aggressive on Ethereum when it was under $200. So again, looking at the return on investment and looking at previous all-time highs, All I need is for Ethereum to get to close to 1,000, 1,100, 1,200, and I could be making similar gains to someone who is trying to get from 8,000 to 100,000. You understand? And I do, again, understand this. I do see that happening. I believe it's probable, highly probable. But again, we're humans, and the human tendency does still come into play when you're holding and you're like, wow, okay, now Bitcoin's at 50,000. Should I cash out now? And then if Bitcoin's at 50,000, 30,000, 40,000, I believe Ethereum should be somewhere near, and I'm being very conservative here. If Bitcoin is at 30,000, 40,000, I strongly believe Ethereum should be somewhere near its all-time highs, which is around 1,400. And I think I'm being conservative. If, you know, with all the things that Ethereum is doing, if Bitcoin is around 30 to 40,000, I could see Ethereum being around 2,000, 2,400. So you see the difference here. Now you're talking about, if you're holding 100 Ethereum, you're not talking about $100,000. Now you're talking closer to $150,000 to $200,000. So again, I believe the smarter play is Ethereum. So that's just my view on this. Just trying to share this thing, share my views in ways so that people can really see this, that I think the smarter play, again, not financial advice, I believe the smarter play is with Ethereum for the better, greater return on investment. Again, not financial advice, just my humble opinion. All right, guys, till next time, stay blessed, be blessed.
Five, four, three, two, one.